Dylan Samuels legally changed his name from William Flynn 10 years ago. What else do we know about him?
He's a scumbag. Got the court transcripts from his divorce. He lied to Sandra Barnes from the start. Spent all her money. Racked up another $300K. Put her in debt all under her name. And accused her of being a drug dealer.
But his testimony says that Sandra stole meds from her own practice. Started using. That's what caused her financial ruin.
Of course he blamed her. What do you expect?
Well, Dylan had credit card and bank statements to back it up.
Because he planned the whole thing. He's probably doing the same thing to his current wife, Candace.
Eyes on the prize here. Sandra was murdered. Candace's daughter's in the ICU. Was Dylan Samuels involved?
Of course he was.
Okay, do we have evidence?
Well, I can't tell you whose car smashed into Dr. Barnes, but can narrow down the make, model, and color based on the traces of paint I got.
Indigo blue?
Yeah, I'm more of a royal blue man myself, but this color was very popular with Chevrolets in the early aughts. Only thing is that there are 2,000 indigo blue Chevys registered in New Orleans.
Dylan Samuels owns one of them. He owns a 2002 Tahoe. He's our suspect.
Well, let's take it one step at a time. You heard Sebastian, there's 2,000 cars in that exact same color.
Are you saying he's innocent?
No, Gregorio, but I'm saying we need to follow the evidence.
I missed something here?
Listen, he changed his name. He has the car. I don't care what the court documents say. Trust me, if anyone knows a con man, it's me. I was married to one.
Ethan McKinley was a jerk.
And a sociopath and a liar.
All of the above. And we trust your instincts, Gregorio. Now go find the proof. Talk to Candace Samuels. See what she can tell you about her husband.
I'm all over it. You coming or what?